Good evening, everyone. Turn up all out. Mentioned that I was short, so I wore heels today just in case. But the truth of the matter is, I look around this room and I want to first applaud each and every one of you for being here. Getting involved in politics in a foreign country is not easy for anybody. But the fact that you are here, most of you born in India or somewhere else, and here engaging in American politics makes me really, really proud as an American citizen. So please give yourselves a big round of applause. What I would like to see is for this whole room to be full and for there to be a line out the door trying to get in. But this is new to our community, political engagement. And there are people stepping forward who need our support. They need us to first be united as a community. When I was growing up in Houston, I was born and raised in Houston. When I was growing up, there was one Indian grocery store. One for the entire city of Houston. Today in Dallas, I don't even know how many Indian grocery stores there are within a 5-mile radius of me because there are more than I can count. That is awesome progress for a community. And with that growth, we've had growth in religious organizations, we've had growth in community organizations, cultural organizations. And as we have come, more and more people from our own communities, our own sub-communities, castes, we have carried a lot of those social constructs from India here to this country. But I will tell you one thing, being an American, being born and raised here. In the 80s, we were just happy to see another Indian. When we ran into an Indian at the grocery store, they became my parents' best friends. And to this day, they still are. Because there was somebody else who looked like us shopping at a Kroger in a rural community. But today, if they're not from the Telugu community, and not only from the Telugu community, but from the specific state and the specific region and from the same caste or whatever, we tend not to engage with them. Oh, they're from North India, but I'm from South India. They like spicy food. They like sweet food. We're not united as a community the way that we should be. And that presents a problem for us as we move forward in greater numbers to be represented in this country. We represent 1.5% of the American population. There are about 550 legislators in Congress. We are not represented at a rate of 1.5% on Capitol Hill. Today, with your support, we have the opportunity to fight to be represented at 1.5% on Capitol Hill. We have got to get behind Erna and help her to get there. So I'm gonna ask you a few questions. I like to engage with people, so I want all of you to be comfortable where you can step away from the table and stand up. Because I wanna ask you this. Number one, are you an American citizen? If you are, stand up. Every one of you, stand up. If you're an American citizen, stand up. If you are registered to vote, stay standing. And if you're not registered to vote, sit down. If you're over 18. First of all, let me say, that is awesome. Every single person standing is registered to vote. I say that is a big check. Give yourselves a round of applause. That is awesome. Secondly, you're registered to vote. Have you actually voted in any election? Any election at all. If you have voted, stay standing. If you have not voted, sit down. So our numbers are starting to drop just a little bit. Now I'm going to ask you those who are standing. Did you vote in a presidential election or did you vote also in a local election? If you only voted in a presidential election and never in a local election, sit down. How many of you who are standing have hosted a meet and greet with somebody running for something in your community? If you have not hosted a meet and greet or have not engaged with a candidate in a meaningful way, take a seat. The numbers are getting smaller. Now I'm gonna go one step further. How many of you have actively campaigned for somebody running for office, locally, nationally, statewide, anything? How many of you have campaigned for them? A few more people said. Last question. How many of you have actively considered running for office, of those of you who are still standing? There are four people still standing in this room. And of you four, how many of you have actually run for office? Let's give, everyone should just give them a standing ovation. I mean, really. Probably one of the hardest things we will ever do as a community, because we're conservative and we're proud. And we don't want people airing dirty laundry about us. We don't want people talking negatively about us. We want to be liked. We want to be respected. That's the community we come from. And when you run for office, people make things up about you, things that aren't even true. People will smear you, smear your family, smear every organization you've ever been associated with, just to help the other person win. So what these two women are doing is one of the bravest things any of us could possibly do. And I really commend you, Arna, for what you're doing, and Lakshmi for what you did. And you'll be running again. And the thing is that we have to come together as a community and get behind people who are brave enough to put their name in the ring, to put their name in the hat, and to stand up and to fight for all of us. Because what we saw during the last presidential election specifically, but what happens during every single election in this country that most of us never pay attention to, is that there is a battle. There is a battle that affects you. It affects your children. It affects your economic situation. It affects your community's education, it affects your safety, it affects everything about you. And yet, we really don't engage the way that we should. So the first thing that we have to do as a community is come together as one Indian American community. One community. Not sub-communities, not be divided behind, you know, various differences that are really arbitrary, to be quite honest, one community. And if we can do that, we stand a chance to be represented for our future and our children's future and well into the future. And today we have the opportunity to get behind Arna. I had the chance to meet Arna back in 2013 when I was asked to serve on a committee, a women's committee, at a Thonic convention that was being hosted here in Dallas. As somebody who attended those boring programs as a child, I was not interested in engaging. That's what people do when they come from India. They go to Thana and Atta and Nata and Naks and Teapot and whatever. I don't even know all of them. But I was asked to serve, and so I did. And that's where I met Arna. Arna and I served on a panel together where we talked about women's empowerment in the community. And that's when I learned what a champion she is for women's initiatives in particular, but community initiatives, family initiatives, as Satish stated, in Maryland. Arna was just elected about a year or two before when we met, but the fact that she was already elected was pretty big, because she had made it. She had been elected. And now she's asking for our support to go one step further to Capitol Hill. And we have got to give her that support. She, as Dania rightly noted, has been a stalwart champion of women's initiatives, in particular, domestic violence, which is an issue that I have worked very closely with as an attorney. She has filed legislation to help protect victims. And for most of you who don't know, and most people in the Indian community don't want to admit, one in four women and one in seven men across the world, including India, maybe more so in certain parts of India, are affected by domestic violence. 25% of the population across the globe. We need people who are champions of women's initiatives. And that's not a women's initiative only, as I mentioned, one in seven men. We need people who are going to take on gun control, because we know that sending children to school and hoping that they come home at the end of the day is not the way you live in a civilized society. You should have the confidence that that child is going to come home at the end of the day. We need Arna to go and fight that particular cause for us in Congress. We need her there, because family is a big part of our community. Hindus are underrepresented in Congress. Indian Christians are underrepresented in Congress. Muslims are underrepresented in Congress. And whenever the issue comes up, certain parties who lean one way or another try to distance themselves from those issues because they don't want to be seen as being in cahoots or bed or whatever you want to call it with people who don't subscribe to certain faiths. We need a candidate who is going to stand up for all faiths. And even people whose views are so distant from our own, but deserve to be heard and deserve to be represented. We need Arna. We need her there. I could go on, but I'll stop there. I'll add one other thing. As the president of the U.S. India Chamber of Commerce, I work very closely with businesses that are interested in engaging in India in very significant ways. Most of them are American companies, multinational companies, that have large interests in investing millions, if not billions, of dollars in India. I'll tell you one of the biggest problems we have right now, and it starts with the administration at the top, and it goes down through Congress. There is no Indian American ambassador to India right now. We've had a president in office for almost a year and a month, who has not seen it necessary to appoint an ambassador to arguably the fastest growing country in the world. And the second, well actually the largest democracy, but one of two of the largest democracies in the world. And more importantly than that, a strategic national security ally to the United States. Inviting Prime Minister Modi to the US was a very political affair. And thankfully, thanks to people like Arna and others who are fighting in Chernobyl and others, that happened. But if we don't have people who are championing those causes in Congress every day, that will become a distant dream, not our immediate reality. So I really, really appreciate all of you being here, and I know that you very generously contributed to be here. But I will stop here and just say, Arna, you have my support. And I truly believe you have the support of everybody in this room. And everybody who contributed who is not in this room. And hats off to the host committee because they really are amazing. Rama and Charanuncle really drove every meeting. We'll be there at 4:30, we'll be there at 5, we'll be there at 7, we're there till 9. And Satish and the rest of our committee really did a lot to make this happen, Navneet Uncle and others. And so I wish you the best of luck. If there's anything any of us in this room can do, and I'm speaking on behalf of everybody, just let us know.
Thank you, Nirvana.